Hi guys, my name is Ximena from Stampin Hime. I am a Stampin Up demonstrator for Europe. I live in Germany, but I am Colombian, so neither German or English are my mother tongue, so I hope you have a little patience with me while I tell you how I made these mini jam jars. I liked the idea so much, so I decided to make a voiceover, English voiceover for this video, so my English speaking friends can see how I did it. I put some bath salts inside in the mini jam jars, and this was a workshop goodie that I gave to the participants from my STEM camp in last May. And yeah, I hope you like the idea. It's really easy to make once you have known the little tricks, and I show you how I did. You will need the bundle for the sweet peach, I think is the English name for this bundle. I used the German one because I'm living in Germany, and I used also the designer papers from the pansy petals. We mostly use all this paper for the stamping camp, especially the backgrounds, like the checks, are the favorite ones, and we use it a lot. You need really a few pieces of paper for this project. You just and here I show you how what I put inside. Of course, you need the jam jar glasses, and there are 6 in a pack, and I love them. They are plastic, so they don't break on the transport. And my special tip for this packaging idea is to use the give it a wool dies. This big circle is bigger than the circle in the layering circles dies. In case you haven't found these wonderful dies, they are in the page 163 from your annual catalog, and you can do a lot of different cards where the greetings are. Yeah, you can move the greetings, but today I use it only for my packaging idea. I used this large circle, as I say, it's almost half centimeter bigger than the layering circle dies, than the largest one. And I found when I used first attempt I did for my packaging was using the largest circle of the layering circle dies, but it was too short. I didn't like it, so I was thinking maybe I will do it if this circle is larger, and it is. It's perfect. And you will get this small hole in the middle of the paper, but don't worry because you will cover it up with some decoration. And this is the second tip I have for you. Just find the middle of your cap, of the lid. And I did that. I just take a scrap of paper and I draw the circle line around the lid. And then I fold the paper 2.5 times so I can find the middle of the circle. I don't know what's the technical name. And then just you take your pick tool and make a mark on your lid or cap, I don't know how you say it. And then you will have the middle. So you can line your paper with the cap so it will lay equally in all sizes when you put it down. I hope you can understand what I mean. You will see. You have to fix the paper with tear and tape, but before you fix the paper, and this I find it's nicer if you do this. It's not a must, but you can. I just took my bone folder and I curved the paper a little bit up on the ends, all around the circle, so it looks a little bit natural when you put it down. It's not so stiff, I don't know. And yeah, it's a little bit of the details is where you get the best results. But it's not complicated, so only you just have to know what to look for, and then you will do this in no time. I did many of these, just be sure to make first all your die cutting, and then all your stamping, and then you can put all together. So, okay, tear and tape. I put, yes, around the lid, around this cap. But then you need to put again on the top, so the paper will not move. And that's it. We made this Stamp Camp as a team event. We do every quarter, one every quarter. We send all the packages with post, and we put the instructions online. We make videos and write PDF instructions for everyone to access them, and they have access for 1 year in a page on my blog. What is happening here? I had to, it is easier if you work with the lid on, and as I said before, you have to fix your paper, so it's easier to make the folding. I use tear and tape also for this part. I think it's the easiest way. I don't think Tombow will work, but probably the Seal Plus will help you out. But tear and tape is definitely my choice to go. And now you just have to pull the paper down. You see, it can be a little bit scary. You normally don't want to do that. But as you can see, it's not that bad. The paper looks good, even a little bit like cloth. And what I'm doing now is just to going over the lines that are naturally forming there. And I'm just pressing down so they keep that way. Sometimes you can choose the direction where the paper will go, and well, I just try to do in different directions so it looks more movement, I don't know, more natural. And since I have my tape waiting there to fix my paper, it's really easy, so it's not moving anymore, and you can work your way around the circle. You can also make a little bit of pressure with the bone folder so it sticking on the tape. Since the tape is put on the lid, it will be no problem to open it again. And the third tip I have for you is to go with your bone folder over on this indent, and this notch from the cap, and go around and make it so that this notch is pressed on your paper. This will make place for the linen thread to go there, so it will not move. It will be easier to fix your thread around the cap, and I found this really useful for me, because when I started attempting this decoration, the thread will go up and down and move like crazy, and so this is best. You can also use a mini glue dot to fix it, but I definitely encourage you to make this little trick. This also helps for the better looking on the decoration, and here I'm helping that natural look. With the paper, pulling up a little bit up. So I didn't like it looking down. So it's almost ready. You just need to put now your linen thread. It's I use it 2 times around the notch, around the cap, sorry, and then I tie a little bow, and that's it. Well, the rest is, I guess you can do the rest without watching the video anymore. If you want to stop now, you can just start making your own. The rest, I just stamped the flowers, and there are flowers and peaches in this stamp, but I really like the flowers, and since my bath salts were not peachy, I think they were kind of mint, I don't know. they really smell good, but it's not peachy, so I didn't want to use the peach image for this, but the flowers were perfect, so I stamped and I cut those. Oh yes, I have this paper around the mini jam jars, and it's around, I will show you with the ruler, it's around 1 inch wide and I think seven and three quarters long. After I got the measurement, and it's 7 3/4 of an inch. Well, since I'm doing this in German and English, then I can as well give you the inch measurements. In centimeters, it's 19.5 centimeters and 2.3 centimeters wide, and on inches, as I said, 7 3/4 of an inch. Well, here I used Tombow for fixing this strap, but it was because it was just around my working space. You can use also a stamping seal, this will help you also. I put glue on both ends, so it will nicely close, and this part I will also put some decoration, so you will not see the connection of the paper binding points, I don't know. That's the main part of my idea. The rest is just decoration. You will need a scrap of paper for doing your stamping. I used pale papaya for the flowers, and for the middle of the flowers I used calypso coral, and for my greeting I used pear pisas. I stamped the flowers 2 times for my decoration, because I will need them for the top of the lid and also for the decoration of the billy band. I will recommend for you to use a stamping mat, so you will get a good impression of your images. And you can die cut all the images from the peach bundle with the mini stands and cut machine. Yes, so all the dies will go through this little one, but the big large dark circle from the give it a whirl dies, it will not pass with this machine, so you will need the big die cut machine anyway. Otherwise, it's really practical to have this little one on your desk. You manage to do things faster. And yeah, you can put it just on the side and keep working. I loved it. I need new plates because I use it so much. So I really need to get new plates, and so that my paper will not be marked. Always make sure to use the same plate under your paper, so there is one plate that you always get the cutting marks, and then you will have one plate without marks where you can always see through. It's important to do that so you can arrange your dies on top of your images and have no problem die cutting. To stamp my greeting, I used strips of paper that are left whenever I cut the layers for my cards, and for all my workshops the participants get envelopes, and also the layers for the personal greetings inside the card, so I have lots of these strips lying around. So I used those, and they were the perfect measure for my greeting. Since I was doing many of those small jars, I stamped many times in one strip the same greeting and just cut it out with the paper snips. It was really easy, and so you don't need to die cut any extra tag for this, and saves you time when you are doing multiples. If you want to make just one, and then of course you can use the one of our beautiful tags, and I cut it with stick musters. This is nice. So as you can see, I was playing around with the arrangement of my flowers on the top of the lid, and attached all of them together with mini glue dots. My greeting, I used mini stamping dimensionals. I also die cut some leaves with the dies from the peach bundle, and I die cut them from Pirpisa's cardstock. I think they are really good complement for my flowers, and it's the same ink I use for, it's the same color I use for my greeting, so it's perfect. Whenever you need to decide the color combination for one project, you can always check the colors on the designer paper you are using, and they will tell you for sure what colors will match with each other. And this is what I do all the time, mostly just check the colors on your designer paper, and 99% of the time they will combine together. Also, I used all the time this pick tool for positioning my flowers and all decoration items. This is perfect also to pick little pieces of paper, like my leaves. So I can just encourage you to use your tool, or to get one if you don't have one. It's really a good investment you can do. Please let me know if you don't have any Stampin Up demonstrator and you live in Europe, then I can help you with your orders and give you recommendation if you wish to, what to buy and how to use it. I'm always here for you. I have also listed all the materials I use for this project, and you can find this list here below on the info box with the links to my online shop. You can send me also an email with your orders or your questions. All my contact details are also listed down below. Okay, that's it. I hope you liked the video. If you do, please leave me a comment give me a thumbs up, and yeah, subscribe my channel. I will make more English videos in the future, but I think also if you follow just the images, you can also get the idea how to do things, even if it's another language. Have fun making this project, and hope to see you soon. Bye bye.